In vehicles having engines with rotating parts of high movement of inertia, gyroscopic forces are in action when the vehicle is changing direction of motion. When automotive vehicles turn with high velocities, gyroscopic forces act on spinning parts such as crankshaft, flywheel, clutch, transmission gears, propeller shaft, and wheels. Engine parts as well as the propeller and the gear reduction system of an aeroplane are under the influence of gyroscopic effects in turns and pullouts. Locomotives and ships are similarly affected. In this unit, we are going to study the gyroscopic and precessional motion of road vehicles, aeroplanes, and ships. The next topic is angular velocity. What is angular velocity? The angular velocity of a rotating body is specified by, first one, the magnitude of velocity. Second one is the direction of the axis of rotor. And the third one is the sense of rotation of the rotor, that is clockwise or counterclockwise. In generally, the angular velocity is represented by a vector in the following manner. First one is magnitude of the velocity is represented by the length of the vector. And the second one is the direction of axis of the rotor is represented by drawing the vector parallel to the axis of the rotor or normal to the plane of the angular velocity. And the third one is sense of rotation of the rotor is denoted by taking the direction of the vector in a set rule. The general rule is that of a right-handed screw rule. That means if a screw is rotated in the clockwise direction, it goes away from the viewer and vice versa. Let us understand this by a small example. In the figure, a rotor which rotates in the clockwise direction when viewed from the end A. Its angular motion has been shown vertically in the figure B. The vector has taken to a scale parallel to the axis of the rotor. The sense of direction of the vector is from A bar to B bar according to the screw rule. However, if the direction of rotation of the rotor is reversed, then it would be taken from B bar to A bar. This is all about angular velocity. Now our topic is angular acceleration. To understand this topic, let us take a rotor which rotate about the horizontal axis OX at a speed of omega radian per second in the direction as shown in this figure. OA bar represents its angular velocity. Just see the figure B. Now, if the magnitude of the angular velocity changes to omega plus del omega and the direction of the axis of spin it changes to OX bar in time del t, the vector OB bar represents its angular velocity in the new position. Now join A bar, B bar, which represents the change in the angular velocity of the rotor. The vector AB bar can be resolved into two components. First component is AC bar. Second component is CB bar. AC bar represents the angular velocity change in a plane normal to AC bar or x-axis. And the CB bar represents angular velocity change in a plane normal to CB bar or y-axis. Now, change in angular velocity AC bar is equal to omega plus del omega into cos del theta minus omega. Now, rate of change of angular velocity is equal to omega plus del omega into cos del theta minus omega whole divided by del t. Therefore, the angular acceleration is equal to limit del t tends to 0, omega plus del omega cos del theta minus omega whole divided by del t. As del t tends to 0, del theta also tends to 0, and cos del theta tends to 1. Therefore, the angular acceleration is equal to limit del t tends to 0, omega plus del omega minus omega whole divided by del t, which is equal to d omega by dt. Next, change of angular velocity CB bar, that is equal to omega plus del omega into sine del theta. Rate of change of angular velocity is equal to omega plus del omega into sine del theta whole divided by del t. Therefore, angular acceleration is equal to limit to del t tends to 0, omega plus del omega sine del theta whole divided by del t. As del t tends to 0, del theta also tends to 0, and sine del theta tends to del theta. Therefore, angular acceleration is equal to limit del t tends to 0, omega plus del omega into del theta whole divided by del t, which is equal to omega into d theta by dt. Therefore, total angular acceleration alpha is equal to d omega by dt plus omega into d theta by dt. That means the total angular acceleration of the rotor is the sum of d omega by dt and omega into d theta by dt. D omega by dt represents change in the magnitude of the angular velocity of the rotor. Omega into d theta by dt represents change in the direction of the axis of spin. The direction of CB bar is from C bar to B bar in the vector diagram, that is being a component of AB bar. And the acceleration acts clockwise in the vertical plane XZ when viewed from front along the Y axis. This is all about angular acceleration. Next topic is gyroscopic couple or gyroscopic torque. Let us take a small rotor which is having the moment of inertia equal to I, and its angular velocity is omega about horizontal axis of spin OX in the direction as shown in the given figure. Let this axis of spin turns through a small angle del theta in the horizontal plane XY. to the position OX bar in a time of del t. Now see the figure B. Figure B shows the vector diagram. OA bar represents the angular velocity vector when the axis is OX, and OB bar represents the angular velocity vector when the axis is changed to OX bar. Now AB bar represents the change in the angular velocity due to change in direction of the axis of spin of the rotor. This change in the angular velocity is clockwise when viewed from A bar towards B bar and is in the vertical plane XZ. This change results in an angular acceleration, the sense and direction of which are the same as that of the change in the angular velocity. Now observe the figure A and B. The change in angular velocity AB bar is equal to omega into delta theta. Angular acceleration alpha is equal to omega into del theta by del t. As the limit, when del t tends to 0, alpha is equal to omega into del theta by del t. Usually, this del theta by del t, it is the angular velocity of the axis of spin, which is called the angular velocity of precession, and it is denoted by omega p. Therefore, the angular acceleration alpha is equal to omega into omega p. Now, the torque required to produce this acceleration is known as the gyroscopic torque, and is a couple which must be applied to the axis of spin to cause it to rotate with the angular velocity omega p about the axis of precession OZ. Therefore, acceleration torque T is equal to I into alpha, which is equal to I into omega p. If you observe the figure A, for this configuration, which is shown in figure A, OX is known as the axis of spin, OZ is known as the axis of precession, OY is known as the axis of gyroscopic couple, YZ is the plane of spin, which is parallel to plane of rotor, XY is the plane of precession, YZ is the plane of gyroscopic couple. The torque obtained above is that which is required to cause the axis of spin to precess in the horizontal plane and is known as the active gyroscopic torque or the applied torque. A reactive gyroscopic torque or reaction torque is also applied to the axis, which it tends to rotate the axis of spin in the opposite direction, that is, in the counterclockwise direction in the above case. Just as the centrifugal force on a rotating body tends to move the body outwards, while a centripetal acceleration acts on it inwards, in the same way, the effects of active and reactive gyroscopic torques can be understood. The effect of the gyroscopic couple on a rotating body is known as gyroscopic effect on the body. A gyroscope is a spinning body which is free to move in other directions under the action of external forces. So this is the expression for gyroscopic couple. So gyroscopic couple T is equal I into omega into omega P. This formula is very, very important in solving the problems. Let us do one problem. A uniform disc having a mass of 8 kg and a radius of gyration of 150 mm is mounted on one end of a horizontal arm of 200 mm length. The other end of the arm can rotate freely in a universal bearing. The disc is given a clockwise spin of 240 rpm as seen from the disc end of the arm. Determine the motion of the disc if the arm remains horizontal. This is the problem. Let us solve the problem step by step. First, what is the given data? Mass of the disc is 8 kg. M is equal to 8 kg. Length of the arm is 200 mm. L is equal to 0.2 meter. Radius of gyration is 150 mm. K is equal to 0.15 meter. Speed of the disc is 240 rpm. N is equal to 240 rpm. Therefore, omega is equal to 2 pi n by 60. That is 2 pi into 240 by 60. 25.13 radian per second. Moment of inertia is equal to mk square. 8 into 0.15 whole square. That is 0.18 kg meter square. We know the formula for couple. Couple C is equal to I into omega P. But we know couple is equal to force into distance. That is, force is nothing but self weight, mg into L. That is the couple. So mg into L is equal to I into omega P. Out of all these, the unknown factor is only omega P. So substitute all the values. M is equal to 8, G is equal to 9.81, L is equal to 0.2. That is equal to I omega P. I is equal to 0.18, omega is 25.13. Substitute all the values, we will get omega P is equal to 3.47 radian per second. As the disc rotates, the weight of the disc acts downwards, and thus a couple about the Y axis in the clockwise direction is applied on the disc. Just observe the figure. The reaction couple is thus counterclockwise, which tends to keep the arm horizontal. Assuming that the axis of spin OX precesses about the Z axis in the counterclockwise direction, the vector OA bar would rotate to the position OB bar in a short period. Then AB bar is the applied couple, and B dash A dash bar is the reaction couple, which is clockwise and tends to give the arm a clockwise rotation about the Y axis, which is not true. Thus, the axis of spin OX must precess about the Z axis in the clockwise direction with an angular velocity of 3.47 radian per second. That is the answer of this problem.